pretty nice. As you can see, I've basically laid the film on the trunk, and now I want to get it as flat as I can before I even start to use the squeegee. So the top face you can see is like glass now, because I just basically pulled it to get it flat this side, that side, very minimal stretch, and now I just want to get the same down the bottom. So we pull it down, get it to lock in, put our fingers on it, push it down, it's going to lock in nice. There we go. It's all locked in. Pull this tight. Try and get as much glass as we can. Lock it all in. Not too worried about this section, because we're going to cut along here, and then this portion we're not going to see, it's going to be behind the trim, so don't worry about that. Just try and get this grease out. That's it. It in places with your finger, keep it from springing back up. It's coming in nicely. Don't even have to use a squeegee at the moment. It's coming in nice. Looking good. Now just pull out this section. I nearly got a boot already. Just make sure you've got no bubbles. Gradually work our way around so it sits nice, taking out the stress on the film, working our way up. Some liquid soap just to smooth it across the paper. Make sure we're locked in. trim for that bit so I can get it flat. Just concentrate on the middle, pushing it down again. So 45 degrees, so it pushes the air out. Okay, you're going to leave that till I open the door, so I can basically get the excess out. Okay, so I'm going to be back in a minute when I just open the trunk. I need to put a hole here for access to open the trunk again, because obviously when you disconnected it, you can't get it open again, right? So I need to connect it back in a minute. Okay, so I'm back with the trunk open. So I'm just going to pull my material so it's like that again, around the edge, as flat as possible. Don't create any creases. If you feel you need some heat here, then fine, use it, but I prefer to use heat as best as possible. Good. Nice first. Okay, see, that's good. Make sure there's no bubbles. Press down hard when you're doing it. You're not going to damage the film when you've already put some lubricant on it. Pull down again, not too hard. More relaxed around the edges of the film, no fingers coming back, the better. It's never going to pull back on itself. I'm working my way around the edge. I'm going to do the same with the other side, make it like glass. Pretty much done. Okay. So I'm going to come back to the middle section. As you can see, I put a slip right away across. You can't see this because it's under the trim section. So all I'm going to do is push it back in again. That's it. Now the air can escape. Sits nice and flat against the concave on the panel. Seeing it out there, may as well get the air out anyway, just to look nice. of mine. Good, so what I'm going to do now is I'm going to heat all the way around the edges just to make the film nice and soft so it can all be folded over to give them the perfect corners. I just put a bit of tension on it to get it nice and cling to the corner. Pull it round so the finish is nice. All the way around. Tension on it, just a little. So it sits in nice. All on its own. Get the idea. Same idea. Bend it round the edge. Follow it nicely. Bent it round, I'm going to kind of superheat it, so I'm just going to keep it on there, turn the temperature up, so I am basically locking it in, what we call post-heating, so when I can smell it burning, I know I'm at the right temperature, just locking it in, keep it moving, don't want to burn the film. A bit of a fine line. You can use a laser heat detector and look at the manufacturer's spec for the film and see what temperature you need to be using. But I tend to know that if you can smell it, then that's a good post-heat temperature. And if you had smell-o-vision, you could smell it. Going to do it all around the curves where we've laid it into to make sure that doesn't ever come back. Very hot to touch, it's good. that's more or less it, apart from the trimming, which is pretty easy. Just trim it on the opposite side, it's good. Okay, I'll show you the finished result.
So, here we have it. Basically finished the trunk. Looks really nice. As you can see, I tell a lie, I haven't finished the trunk. I need to do the centerpiece there, but I need the car, so I'll have to do that at a later date, but I'll show you when it's finished. But everything is nice and neat. Need to get a new trim for the belt line there, but when that's on the car, that will complete it lovely. Don't forget to subscribe to any of our videos, and you can keep up with the progress of the Mini or all the other wraps that I do. I've got a Camaro next weekend to do, so I'll upload a video of that. But please subscribe, like, comment, anything you don't like or do like, please feel free to comment and I will answer. So hope you enjoy the videos. Keep following. Bye for now.